Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. Today's video is on clause. In this video, we're going to study the different types of clause and the subcategories of clause. I'm also going to show you how to identify the different types of clause and their functions in a sentence. Now, let's get started. A clause is a group of words with a finite verb that form part of a sentence. A finite verb is a verb that can stand on its own in a sentence. For example, if I say John is a man, is the finite verb in that sentence. But when I say John is sitting on a chair, is no longer be a finite verb. Rather, it will become an auxiliary verb, helping the main verb sitting. So, a finite verb is a verb that carries the sense of a sentence. Clause is categorized into two major parts. That's the main clause or the independent clause and the subordinate clause or the dependent clause. The main clause is like a simple sentence. It can make a complete sense when it is detached from a sentence. For example, if I say, give me the money which you took from the drawer. Give me the money is the main clause of that sentence. Because without the rest of the sentence, it can actually make a complete sense. When you tell somebody, give me the money, the person actually understands what you mean. So that takes us to the second type of clause, which is subordinate clause or dependent clause. A subordinate clause is a clause that cannot stand on its own when detached from a sentence and make a complete sense. It depends on the main clause to make a complete sense. In the example, give me the money which you took from me. Which you took from me is a subordinate clause, depending on the main clause, give me the money, to make a complete sense. Subordinate clause is further categorized into three: noun clause, adjective clause, and adverb clause. Noun clause. A noun clause is a clause that performs the functions of a noun in a sentence. It can function as the subject of a verb, object of a verb, or object of a preposition. Subject of a verb, object of a verb, or object of a preposition. When it functions as the subject of a verb, it usually comes before the verb. For example, if I say, what makes Nigeria rich is oil. What makes Nigeria rich is oil. What makes Nigeria rich is a noun clause, and it functions as the subject of the verb is. Another example, how the robbers escaped remains a mystery to us. How the robbers escaped is a noun clause. Qualifying the verb remains. Like I said, a noun clause can also function as the object of a verb. And when it functions as the object of a verb, it usually comes after the verb. For example, I saw what the boy did. What the boy did is a noun clause functioning as the object of the verb saw. Another example, please tell me what you know about this. What you know about this is a noun clause functioning as the object of the verb tell. A noun clause can also function as the object of a preposition, like I said earlier. When a noun clause functions as the object of a preposition, it comes after the preposition. Prepositions include words like in, at, on, over, about, around, through, into, and so many others. Prepositions are usually used to show place and directions. So when a noun clause comes after a preposition, it functions as the object of the preposition. Let's look at some examples. Give these discarded books to whoever asks for them. Whoever asks for them is a noun clause functioning as the object of the preposition to. Another example, your success depends on how you use your time. Your success depends on how you use your time. How you use your time is a noun clause functioning as the object of the preposition on. The next one we'll look at is adjective clause. Adjective clause is a clause that qualifies or modifies a noun or pronoun. The house which Jack built has collapsed. If I underline which Jack built is an adjective clause qualifying the noun, the house. People who break the law should be punished. If I underline who break the law is an adjective clause qualifying the noun, people. Another example. The girls were able to identify the robbers who terrorized them. Who terrorized them is an adjective clause qualifying the noun, robbers. Now let's move to the third type of subordinate clause, which is the adverb clause. Adverb clause performs the function of an adverb, which is to qualify or modify a verb, an adjective, or another adverb. Adverb clause is further categorized into adverb clause of time, adverb clause of reason, adverb clause of place, adverb clause of concession and contrast, adverb clause of manner, and adverb clause of proportion. We're going to start with adverb clause of time. Adverb clause of time answers the question when. They're usually introduced by words like when, whenever, after, until, till, since, all the time, ever since, as soon as, and so many others. The important thing to note is that adverb clause of time tells you when or the duration of time. Let's look at some examples. Whenever he is here, he quarrels with everyone. Whenever he is here is an adverb clause of time, qualifying the verb quarrels. Remember, adverb always qualify a verb, an adjective, or another adverb. He kept on working until John arrived. Until John arrived is an adverb clause of time, qualifying the verb working. As soon as he arrived, he reported to the manager. As soon as he arrived, he reported to the manager. As soon as he arrived is an adverb clause of time, qualifying the verb reported. The next type of adverb clause that we're going to look at is adverb clause of place. Adverb clause of place answers the question where. It's usually introduced by words like where, wherever, whither, and so on. Now let's look at some examples. Wherever we are is our home. Wherever we are is an adverb clause of place, qualifying the verb is. This is the place where it all happened. Where it all happened is an adverb clause of place, qualifying the verb is. Now let's look at adverb clause of condition. Adverb clause of condition answers the question on what condition. It is usually introduced by words like unless, if, provided, so long as, in case, and so on. Let's look at some examples. If I'm invited, I will be there. If I'm invited is an adverb clause of condition, qualifying the verb be. Unless you hurry up, you'll be late for the meeting. Unless you hurry up is an adverb clause of condition, qualifying the verb late. Now let's consider adverb clause of concession and contrast. Adverb clause of concession and contrast: while, with, although, though, whereas, whoever, whatever, wherever, whereas, however. Another clause of concession and contrast: the subordinate clause usually contrasts the main clause. Let's look at some examples. John is very strong, although he is young. Another example: even if it rains, the function must hold. Even if it rains is an adverb clause of concession and contrast, and it qualifies the verb hold. The next type of adverb clause we'll consider is adverb clause of comparison and degree. Adverb clause of comparison and degree compares and answers the question to what extent. Let's look at some examples. The lady in white is more beautiful than the lady in red. The lady in white is more beautiful than the lady in red. More beautiful than the lady in red is another clause of comparison and degree, and it qualifies the verb is. Another example: Mary is as old as Jane. They are twins. As old as Jane is another clause of comparison and degree, and it qualifies is. Now let's look at adverb clause of manner. Adverb clause of manner answers the question how, and they are usually introduced by words like as though, and as if. Let's look at some examples. Look as if you are tired. As if you are tired is an adverb clause of manner because it answers the question how, and it qualifies the verb look. Lastly, let's look at adverb clause of proportion. Adverb clause of proportion is usually introduced by words like the more, the less, the more, the better, as, and than. Now let's look at some examples. The more he worked on the project, the less he achieved. The more he worked on the project is an adverb clause of proportion, qualifying the verb achieve. And if the video has been helpful, click on the subscribe button and on the notification bell so that you can get instant notification whenever I upload a new video.